Hello, my name is Michael Baldassare. The government seems to be afraid that the people might think for themselves. I would start by taking a third off of whatever salary I get from being elected to any office I'm in, at least a third. I should be able to live on that and still do what people want me to do, and they should too. The name of our church is the Assembly of the Church of the Universe. I became a missionary in 1979, in and out of court forever over this marijuana thing. Because we believe marijuana is God's tree of life. From what I've read in the Bible, is to do unto others as you would have others do unto you. Just like to cut it up a little bit. Probably not all that necessary. That's about the size of it there. I think so, yeah, I believe so. Sacred, it's God's tree of life as far as I'm concerned. It's the only plant that I know of that has a name in every culture of the world. Not just in Latin, where it's called cannabis. No, every culture of the world. Every tribe of the native can Canada in the United States, if you ask them. They have different languages, will have a different name for this plant all over Earth. Never killed anybody, and it's illegal. That's ridiculous. It's as ridiculous as our governments, like McGuinty, $500 million. Why, is he stupid? He doesn't know that maybe the people don't want that there. That's the kind of thing, you figure you're hiring a politician because he's got some parts. And that goes for the whole whack of them. I'm getting tired of this. Let's spend thousands of dollars on consultants. They're supposed to be my consultants. It's maybe time we had a means test for politicians, because it doesn't matter whether you like them. You always end up hating them anyway. So let's send them to school. If they're going to run our country, I want a means test. I got more means to operate this country than the people that are running it. So do most Canadians. First thing they can do is take a third off their paychecks. And then they should take the lowest pension that they expect any other Canadian to live out. Live on. Then I might have some respect for these people, but they're on a platform right now and I'm not happy. So I'll just keep running and running and running until maybe the people understand you got to put your own people in. Mice vote for mice, not big fat cats. Tommy Douglas will tell you that. My doctor was brave enough to give me to stand behind my need to kill pain so he gave me a prescription for marijuana. The issue is it's my religion. I just need a prescription, and I need to grow acres of it, fields of it, because our church, we have a church here that the government's attempting to kill. It's illegal because Mark Emery pled guilty to passing a joint. That's trafficking. And you're not supposed to pass your medicine, but there's a whole religious aspect that's being lost here. If it's safe enough for medicine, surely the people with this plant, this particular plant, can... They don't fight. They don't just ask any cop who's ever worked around the bar area when marijuana was legal back in the early 2000s, and they'll tell you that they had less trouble in Hess Village than they ever had. And these are guys that worked that till they retired, were telling me this. It also goes out. You know when you get a grass fire? They used to use this, used to grow rows of marijuana to kill the flames. California doesn't need to burn. What they need to do is grow some marijuana around their cities. So if there is a brush fire and that tumbleweed they got, that stuff is like a gasoline plant. It'll hit the marijuana and go out. And meanwhile, they can be making rope out of it and oil and operating. Henry Ford owned the marijuana farm and he made a car and ran it out of marijuana. That was a Mexican name for the hemp plant, of course. This is just so ridiculous, it's not funny anymore. I've been at this for a long time. I'm just waiting for stupid to stop being so. There's two types of marijuana, basically. You have cannabis sativa, which is a... Like, if you look at cold medicine, there's daytime and nighttime. If you want to go to bed, smoke indica. That's the plant that grows up in the mountains. Short little bud, it'll knock you out. You can go to sleep. You want to be up and get some work done and feel energetic, smoke cannabis sativa. Real simple. There's nothing to it. But how many varieties there are, and we have done no study on the tree of life. We just make it illegal, and if it has THC in it, and that's not so. There's no two plants that are alike. They're like people. Somewhere along the line, wouldn't it be neat if the Bible was right and we are immortal and we get to live forever? I mean, to me, that's what it's all about, doing unto others. This church, your first rule here is to treat other people the way you want to be treated. And that's what Jesus said. And you don't have to be a Christian to belong to the church. You don't just have to agree with common sense. And that man spoke common sense every time he talked. And I'm not a Christian, but I love my brother Jesus. And we'll have to... When I die, I'm going off by myself, eh? Just like everybody that's gone before me. My spirit will carry on. Or maybe not everybody has a spirit. Nothing matters, because what I believe is revelations. God comes back. Our people come back, obviously in spaceships. If they're up there in outer space, I don't know how they manage to come back. Chances are we've been here forever. This Earth has been hit by another planet. We know that. That's just fact. That's how we got the moon. Maybe we lived here before and we got the heck out of the way. I don't know. But if you look at the New Jerusalem in chapter 21 of Revelations, I've had two mathematicians now measure the size of the city and the height. It sticks into space beyond Earth's gravitational pull. That is a docking station. And the walls are crystal clear, like glass. They're gold. The last impurity in gold is the color. You take the color out and you've got a gold glass. The best conductor, they can't put a ship in space without coating it in gold to block the ultraviolet lights that are emitted from deep space. So, interesting, isn't it? This is just a hobby of mine. I truly hope somebody's coming by to clean up the oceans, because it's left to our own. It ain't happening, guys. But I do have faith in mankind. I'll not give it up, so I'll just keep running for whatever office you want to elect me to. And as far as church goes, pray in your closets, because until we can straighten this government mess out in the Supreme Court, which we're working on, hopefully this year I'll be at it, and some other brothers, so that we can gather, just do like Jesus said, pray in the closet, because they're throwing you in the lion pits. Those are little lions meowing at you that want to eat you. That doesn't look so bad, because the children's aid only stole the children because the mother was smoking a joint. But they'll walk into a house full of beer bottles and just do nothing. Oh no, it's time to stop. And anyway, that's pretty much it. God bless. What can I say? You got a lot of stuff just there.
I know, but I need to get you to introduce yourself and say a few other things that I, you know,
well, okay,
to the main topics.
All right, let's look straight ahead. Michael, similarity.
Yeah.
64, 62, close enough. Knitted original hats, similar. Okay, the rest of it, there's a lot of differences. I have never smoked a joint in my life. And it's a personal record. It's a difference. The religion business, I can't say I follow any particular religion. So do you want to fill in the gaps there?
Oh, do you follow your own religion?
Yes, absolutely.
Well, that's all there is. The Church of the Universe is not a religion. It's a church.
There you are.
Yes. People have the religion, and you want to see God, look in the mirror.
I agree with you. So now we're getting closer. We're getting onto parallel lines.
Yeah.
Can we see each other without our hats?
Yeah, I'll take my hat off for the people of the
All right.
universe.
I can't see us. I haven't seen you without your hat. How are we? Similar?
Good. You know that little light there, if you could move it?
This light here?
Oh.
There you go.
We could shut it off.
Leave it on.
That's good.
Are we good?
That's nicer. Okay. Nice.
Is there a brotherhood developing here? Are we?
Yes.
Can we be close?
Yes. I think so, yeah.
Yes.
Hey,
hey, brother.
I'm really happy to be doing this with you.
Thank you, likewise.
Looking in the mirror to see God. Yeah, I like that.
To introduce yourself any way you like. Go ahead.
Hi, I'm Brother Michael.
Do Should we do one with Michael Baldassaro or not? Go ahead.
Hi, I'm Michael Baldassaro.
Okay, let's try it again. Maybe you can do one of Brother Michael Baldassaro.
Ah.
You want to do that? Hang on a second. I'm going to go really fast. I'll point to you when I'm ready.
Hello. My name is Michael Baldassaro.
History.
I was born in Manitoulin Island in 1949. Came to Hamilton about 1950. That's it. It's not a very exciting life.
It's fine. Talk about your engineering background or your dad's engineering, anything.
Well, my dad, he was a general contractor and he built the Kenilworth Cut when I was a young man. Oh, a child, actually.
Church.
The Church of the Universe started in 1969 officially, and out of the need to have a church and its purpose for the gather of the people. Not to tell the people how to worship, but just if you believe in God, you need a church. As far as I'm concerned, that's a good thing. Brother Walter felt the same way. So here we are. We created some stars and made some logos. Let's see. Well, aside from being prosecuted an awful lot because we believe marijuana is God's tree of life, which in and out of jail. It's hard to believe. I was told at times that my God wasn't looking after me as well as the prosecutor's God was. And I thought we had straightened out there was only one God. I won't bother to say what religion she was because that doesn't necessarily mean everybody in her sect feels that way.
Do you want to mention Brother Walter a little more?
Brother Walter? Well, he was the founder of the church, for sure. It all happened around him. And well, he's gone on now, so I imagine I'll just carry on the church and catch up to him. It's hard to say what we are because it's hard for us to gather. I think that they're afraid. The government seems to be afraid that the people might think for themselves and maybe, well, of course, a lot of our people like to be naked. Not that you have to be, but I guess you'd say we're sort of a New Age church. But the golden rule is the golden rule, and that's the only one that needs to be kept, from what I've read in the Bible, is to do unto others as you would have others do unto you. And that's the only rule that's enforceable. I've never met another creature that wanted to be hurt. So it should work, but it's on this planet, nothing works. We just pray that God comes back, like the Bible promised, and straightens it all out. And in the meantime, we're going to be judged according to our works and how we treated others, basically. And we're already going to know that, according to what I've read. And this God can raise all the dead, because things are only matter. So if you don't believe in aliens, you have to remember we're aliens to somebody else because we're only one of trillions and trillions of solar systems. There's got to be more life out there, and we're up there, and I think I've said that before. I firmly believe and hope there is intelligent life out there.
Hamilton?
Oh, yeah, I ran down in Ward 3, Hamilton downtown, basically, east. And in each of all three elections, the municipal, and I was glad to see Mayor Petrina get elected because he does say what is on his mind. That's refreshing. I ran against, Andrea
Horvath,
yes, Andrea. And I accused her of giving her party of giving the government of Canada over to the Conservatives, and they did. I know it's a different level, but it's all the same thing. It's all the same ponies. And then there was the federal election with Mr. Christofferson. I accused him of getting paid too much, and he very reluctantly stood up when I sang "Oh Canada." But I must say, my friend Jimmy Byron, he stood up and sang along with me. He was running for the Conservative Party. He had the guts to stand up. The other guy, nah. And it's a perfect example of these people. There should be a means to us to be a politician because they may be very likable. And you might think, oh, he did something for me. I'll tell you right now, that's their job. And what they should be doing, these people, is not getting little bonus points because they helped anybody. No, making sure that everybody's being helped by somebody at City Hall. And the heck with the credits. That's how I feel about it. And you know, people aren't going to like it. We need austerity across the board. But it's got to start with our leaders, or nobody else wants any part of it. But things aren't working out. Who's going south now? Oh, Caterpillar's going to the States. They're shutting the 300 people out of work here in Ontario. This isn't good. We've got to... And they're leaving because we're getting too much money. I know we're worth more than they're giving us, but it's grossly unbalanced. And no matter what, it's got to come in line. And I would start by taking a third off of whatever salary I get from being elected to any office I'm in, at least a third. If I can't, I should be able to live on that and still do what people want me to do. And they should too. And they shouldn't be wasting our money. And politics should have nothing to do with running the government. It should just be grandstanding the people and showing what they, who they are and what they might be able to do if you elected them, based on all kinds of stuff that they've got going for them between their ears, giving them more time. Because in elections, I'm lucky to get a minute to say anything. And what do you say if you had a whole minute and elect me? Why? And there's 15 candidates for mayor running. If anything I did, I'm the reason Mayor Morrow didn't get acclaimed. That's my claim to fame.
How many votes were you able to drum up? Close to
7,000? 7,000 votes in that election, which was really a vote against Bob and Mayor Morrow. And I wasn't... It's what politics, I guess, at the time were from the times before. But these are the people that tore the heart out of Hamilton, tore the old City Hall down, put the blocks, just the concrete, the rock that built the old City Hall belongs now in the golf course in Ancaster. It's unbelievable. As a child, I looked at this beautiful building, and then it disappeared to make Jackson Square. It should have been part of Jackson Square. It had something to do with Eaton's. It's just like everything else at City Hall. Somebody seems to have plans, and then we get an election and a minute to cover all the candidates and please elect the guy who you're afraid the other guy is going. You're always voting against something, never for, right? Always against. That's what the first presidents of the United States said in their famous sayings. People did. Never voted for, always against. Even in the last election, they were voting against, well, who was running, Julie? Mayor Eisenberger?
Eisenberger.
Fred.
I like Fred. I like them all, actually. There's Fred, and who was the other guy? Mayor...
Deani,
yeah.
That's right.
Okay, we had two mayor guys running. And Bob Bertina sits down beside me at the first meeting, and he says, Mike, I'm going to tell you right now, the only reason I'm running is because my friends figure if I didn't, you might win. Because everybody didn't like those other guys so much. That, if to believe him or not, I know, at least he had the guts to say what's on his mind all the time. You may not like Bob, but this shouldn't be a liking contest. Let's see what his accomplishments, like with Mayor Ford. Does he have any? Does he have the capability of running the city? If that'll show, I don't care whether everybody hates him. That's mainly because they don't want to listen to him. But I never found Bob to be a man who I mean, he's been on a talk show for an awful long time. You should be able to speak your mind. And these people keep going after poor Bob. Anyway, I don't want to sound like I'm defending the man, but I read the paper today, and there they are wasting more of our time trying to scold Bob for being abrasive. He is. He threw a pencil at me once. But you just have to understand he's a bit of a sportsman. I think he plays hockey too, you know. But
he thinks the world of you.
Yeah, he never hit me with his pencil. It was just his way of...
He's excited. He's very passionate.
Well, I took him by surprise at the council, at the... I was running for mayor, I guess, or something. I guess he was. But no, it was councillor the first time he got elected. And I gave my votes to Judy Mon... Pardon?
Musitano.
Judy Musitano. I gave my votes to... he says to me afterwards, why didn't you give me those votes? He says, well, I didn't, you know, Bob. I don't know, ladies first. Judy is an accomplished lady and a nurse. She would have made a good councillor in Ward 3. And Bob, well, you know, he won because he's popular. And he's smart. I've heard him on the radio. He's not a dummy. And he speaks his mind. He doesn't suffer fools. And that's the problem. I didn't understand. Bob won't repeat.
He's an accomplished musician. He's a talented man.
Yeah. So I'd like to see council just get, quit with this stuff. You hurt my widow feelings. You're not treating me good. And get on with saving us some money. And explaining to me what they're doing with our city. Like, why did we tear down the old city hall? Where did the Hamilton Center Mall go? They've destroyed it. Yeah, it's really good for commerce and big box stores. Those are the ones in the old elections we were running against. We were promised there'd be no big box stores. There'd be no Link. And we got a Link and the boxes are getting just bigger and bigger. Anyway, the Center Mall sickens me and a whole lot of other people. That was a community center. You would think they could have built that in and just kept the heart of it. No. Anyway.
At least keep the jockey club.
Well, the jockey club. Yeah. Well, why not, really? Like, it worked. I don't know. I just don't understand it. Now we've got a car mall. And you watch people. How do people? Like, we used to go in the mall. We had Santa Claus. We had people with walkers. And people are getting along, eh? And now there's hardly any sidewalks, and there's cars all over the place.
So it's designed for cars.
Wind, rain, and it's no longer a place where people could go and spend the afternoon shopping, and it was wonderful. For these people, and Brother Walter and I went before the council, and not one of them wanted to hear about turning that place into a heritage site. First mall in Canada. First closed-in mall in Canada. And they told me, well, we're going to save the arches and put them somewhere and call it a smart center. The smart center on Barton, right? Dumbest thing I ever saw. Like, we need a place to gather. They keep dividing and separating us. Divide and conquer. Can't even get that Santa Claus anymore.
You might play a good role in that.
I know. It's like a curse. My mother said always, you should play Santa Claus. And I turn out to look like him. I've had little kids point at me and they'll go, Mom, look, a Santa Claus, right? A Santa. Just little kids, so innocent. But I like, that's beautiful. I don't believe in Santa. I did, never did. I was hurt enough when Superman got shot. I thought he was immortal. Just one thing after the other, We really should stop lying to our children. And maybe ourselves, but that's a big pill to swallow.
That's a whole different topic.
Yes, it is. Well, I'm a hoisting engineer because my father, he owned a large construction company. And I guess 1967, I quit school, grade 9, and went to work for him. And ended up running all of his equipment and cranes and stuff. And so the license just came because I was doing it. I was very, very fortunate to have an opportunity like that. But those days, there was no school for doing it. You just went out and did it. So that's what I did. And then I got in a couple of accidents. So I'm recovering from that.
When did the Church of the Universe start?
No, 1969. But for me, I became a missionary in 1979. After I'd been hurt again, I got whacked on the machine. Got hit on the back of the head by a door, and took me 22 years for the compensation people to quit screwing me because they didn't like the Church of the Universe, basically. Still working on that one, too. So that's how I got here. But in and out of courts forever over this marijuana thing, it really makes it hard to be a church. Like, when people say, oh, is the church recognized? Well, you want the government to recognize the church so you can go to it? Then you might as well go to the Church of England. Because the Roman Catholic Church doesn't recognize the Church of England. That's what the Magna Carta was all about. It was about, they didn't want to recognize the Church of Rome, England. They've always fought, and they still do. In any event, no, I don't care whether they like us or not. We exist, and we're different. And yes, the church had property here. The government stole it when we sold, between us, $80 worth of marijuana. They took the building the church owned on Barton Street here. And you can see Brother Walter on that stop sign with him going like that. I'm sure you all got a picture. Yeah, we got half of that back on appeal, but we lost the whole building over $40, $80 worth of marijuana. And I went to the prison for 2 years. They threw me in the pen for 2 years. A guy just got 2 years of house arrest for 200 pounds driving it across Canada. That's trafficking. And he got, anyway, they threw me in there with probably the guy who raped your grandmother last night. For real. We're smoking pot, right? It's a bloody nightmare. Anyway, our prison system's a horror which needs to be addressed, but unless you know about it like I do, you don't know how to do that. And that's another reason I'd like to get elected to something, or I can stir the pot, you know, because nothing's happening. They put you on as a backbencher everywhere if you have something to say. But I'd like to change all that.
So was that what was a G you doing?
Yeah. Yeah. Well, I don't really. All you can do.
I'm a rookie at that myself.
Yeah, me too. I never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away.
With a duet.
Well, you can come over and play anytime. We get really good and we practice, you know. I'm going to start recording myself because I know I have no control over my voice. I know it's all over the place. Well, this is the main entrance, of course, to what we call Clearwater Abbey, a little swamp to my right. This road we used to leave it with holes. It's the only way to get people to slow down, eh? It's not God's natural speed bumps. The house was just up here. Well, I haven't got much to say. The house is up here on the left. It's still about 200 feet away. Well, in 1970, I came here camping with my wife, with my 340 CUDA, pulling a little trailer at the back. It was neat. This is where the house was here, the septic tank. Our marijuana patch is back there. Yeah, this would have been the house on our left here. Completely leveled. Well, I guess we would be sitting here, right about, it was in here. That was behind the house. Beautiful, beautiful house, how hand-built by Walter. They said he could live here forever, and they'd never need the property to mine. They never mean a thing they say either. So he built a house that was incredible. They said he would be a watchman no matter what. Well, things happen, people sell property and things get tossed out. That isn't what it used to be. This was beautiful. This is where hippies could be. But kill the flower people, my God, and then we'll take it over as if we're some kind of environmentalists. They call themselves naturalists, yet I've never seen any one of them with their clothes off. Natural to them is building boardwalks and controlling river, damming rivers to make hydroelectric dams. That's how natural these people are. The Hamilton Region Conservation Authority and the naturalists just couldn't stand the hippies. Just couldn't let them be. They could swim naked. No, no, if they can't sell alcohol, they don't want it. And this place was too hard for them to control. But nobody was getting hurt. And Brother Walter should have been allowed. They should have at least recognized his right to stay here and look after this place as what it was. You could just come here and either take your clothes off or leave them on. The only rules were don't hurt yourself and don't hurt anyone else. That was it. A lot of memories. It was hard for Brother Walter. He had a right to be here. To stay here till he was dead. That's what they should have honored, but they don't honor anything. They don't honor our pension plans, nothing at all. Only thing they honor is everything they're getting. There's no honor at all to the honorable men. I lived there. There was a shack, all made out of stone. It's gone. They just tore all the heritage stuff out of here. They just don't, they're afraid some hippie will come by and smoke a joint and maybe take their clothes off. That's very natural. Hardly a threat. Anyway, when Reverend Tucker came here, this place was being used by bike gangs and all sorts of trouble. They were afraid somebody was going to drown, so they begged him to come, and he scuba dived here. And that's how he found out about the place, and he agreed with Canada Stone. And that's where they made the agreement. Of course, when Steatley Industries Limited bought it, all that changed. Eh? All of a sudden, they wanted it for themselves. Of course, they didn't get it either, because we were hard to get rid of, very hard. It took them years and years and years. If we had a jury in a proper court, that never would have happened. Anyway, I doubt I'll live long enough to see any real justice, but maybe make some minor changes would be nice. The Reverend Tucker and I have changed some laws. Trespass the Property Act for one. There's going to be water down here for drinking. Even my dad was here. I brought him up. He wanted to see it. He didn't believe in being naked, but he wasn't against us being here doing that. There's nowhere to go to be natural in this country. They call this a free country. Yeah, free to keep your bathing suit on and obey the government's stupid laws that make no sense and go unchallenged because they don't allow them to be challenged. Marijuana laws have never been challenged, ever. I've had judges agree we were right, and then next time we see them, they forgot completely. So they got shit for agreeing with me, one judge, Justice Martin, Court of Appeal for Ontario. He agreed with me marijuana laws were not a matter of criminal law. The other two judges got really pissed at him, really angry. Took him in the back chambers. Martin, he writes the annual criminal code, eh? So it's no small judge. No. Politics has ruined everything. And there's judges that don't know the law. The ones that do, I have no trouble with. It's the ones that are in there serving big pharma and the oil companies. They're the ones I give me some justice. And I've met some judges I respect, so they're not. But there's not enough. You get to the Supreme Court of Canada and they don't want to hear anything unless they get 10 million old people shaking their canes at them saying, we won't elect you next time. We will vote for the other guy. That's when the courts seem to care. They hauled a lot of rock out of there over a lot of years. Built a lot of roads. Number 6 highway, the original, was probably a lot of it built up here out of this quarry. all the side streets. The summer of 69, man. I was here at 69 at the other end, but in 70, it was hippie-dum. It was great. Bare feet, sandals, just walking around naked, the sun shining, smoking doobs. I'd had the odd beer back then. It was nice, but there's no place like it in the world. We lived it, Walter and I. I'm very thankful for that. So was he. Not just because we got tossed out of heaven doesn't mean anything. Nobody else has even had a glimpse of it here on earth. We have. It was here. They just couldn't leave well enough alone. They had to get rid of them. The people that, well, now look at it. It just sits here. 1970 was a great summer. Now, 70, here we were, eh? Naked. I just started smoking marijuana the year before, the very end of it. I guess I was 20, 21. And everything was so new, like the big folk festival in the States. What do you call it?
Woodstock.
Woodstock, yeah. Brother Raymond, he was here, and he had actually played on one of the small stages there. He was a friend of mine. I brought him here. He became a lifeguard that summer. There are a lot of good young people that, you know, a lot of them are dead now. We're getting older, eh, with the baby boomers. We had a treehouse over here, camping all back in there. It was beautiful. Just loved it. Just the other side of it. We called it the treehouse. I think the foundation's still there. I used to camp up in here, different people camp. There's hills and there's flat spots back in there, and a road goes that way. After all these years, we were hauled out of here so many times for trespassing, Walter and I. They're so afraid he was going to move back in. We did try once or twice.
Oh, were they keeping security 24 hours a day here?
Oh, at one time, yeah. That's why, no, they backfilled the quarry. You see, there's the road going down to the quarry there. The road, you can see it. And the quarry would be to the left.
I see that.
We're going to go and have a good look at it over here. I'll show you where I met Brother Walter. Yeah, you do that. Here's the treehouse here. The foundations are here. See, there is the main foundation for it. And we had built this big, huge house on top of it.
That's pretty damn serious. That's
it was.
Rocking,
you know Kelly J?
Yeah, I know Kelly J.
He has had a piano in there.
It's in there still?
No, well, the house is gone. Oh, yeah, Crowbar used to come up here and party back in the 70s. This was a real spot. Everything peaceful and kosher.
Yeah, we're friends on Facebook with Kelly J. He's down the States now.
Yeah, yeah. Well, there it is there. Kelly J's treehouse. Walter, Ray, we had all kinds of good hashish.
Was King Biscuit Boy with like Crowbar too or not?
I believe so. I don't know if he, I don't know everybody by name up here, and I wasn't privy to all the times. I got serious in 1979 because God told me to come back here and be a minister of the church. I received those instructions in Manitoulin Island when I went to talk to the Spirit, to the Creator. And I came back and became a minister, a missionary, then a minister. That was in 1979. I've been a member, though, of the church since 1970. Makes sense to me.
Give me the title of the church.
The Assembly of the Church of the Universe.
I'm ready.
The Assembly of the Church of the Universe. We are at Clearwater Abbey, Puss Lynch, Ontario. The name of our church is the Assembly of the Church of the Universe.
Yeah. You did it like you're painting by numbers. Look my way. Turn this way, Michael. This is good. Okay.
Maybe a joint would help.
Yeah, maybe. I don't know. You want to do that? It's fine with me.
We'll do that later.
Say it again.
The Assembly of the Church of the Universe, Clearwater Abbey, Puslinch, Ontario.
Okay.
And the resting place of Reverend Tucker.
You want to call it Brother Walter? Because that's how you refer to him all this time, eh?
Okay.
Reverend Brother.
Well, the resting place of Brother Walter, the most right Reverend Brother Walter A. Tucker. Wally's World also. That's what they used to call it, Wally's World. We're going to where I met Reverend Brother Walter Tucker over here. No, you'll see it when you're...
Is it even clear when we get ahead?
Oh, yeah. This was all the quarry. They've destroyed all the walls and Shaw moved it way back. It was 30-some feet deep.
Is that what this is called, Fletcher Creek?
No, yeah. Conservation.
This is a good spot.
This is where we met, Walter and I. We smoked a joint here. First time I met him. We used to dive off the rocks here. They've changed stuff, you know. This is pretty much, couldn't be changed, but down there, we used to dive in there. That was 30 feet deep. All that rock they took out, they poured in here. To make that.
When did you meet? Was it the late 60s?
1970, right here.
70.
We're sitting here smoking a doob. Me, him, and his son. Right about here. There are people all over the place. It was the end of the day.
Okay, stop a second. I'm coming around. I'm going to get the rest of it from down here.
Yeah.
Don't worry, I'm not going to fall. I'm okay. Carry on.
Yeah, it was the end of the day that we met here. We sat here and smoked a doob. Maybe I should light one up. Okay. This might be just the place to do it.
In honor of... Brother Walter.
Well, yeah.
I should get my ass down further down.
Yeah.
Should I or not? Not. I'll be here. Maybe here.
No, you can go down there.
It's all right. Don't go too far.
You can go down there. See, we used to climb down here, but they've got
Should we go down by the water then, maybe? What?
Well,
what?
We can go over there, because yeah. That's where... They okay. See, the ashes are up there.
Hang on a second. Oh, before you light up then, let me shut this thing off. Hang on.
The ashes are over there.
Okay.
Well, I don't think we should go down this way.
No, okay.
No, I think we should go follow me, yeah.
Right.
Yeah, that's too fucking steep.
Okay.
There's no point in getting hurt.
I was ready to do it, too.
I'm too hot. First time I ever came here, I camped, eh? It was neat at night, really stoned right around the dark.
Okay, we're good. So where was it, around here?
I used to camp. There'd be tents in here and all the back in there.
What a spot. This is great.
And there's a ruins there of the crusher ship. Remember I told you?
Yeah.
Used to pull the stuff up here.
This would take years to excavate and extract
all
the stones.
Bastards. Well, it wasn't so hard to fucking fill it in. He just chipped the stone away and backfilled it. It was just such a gorgeous quarry. Like right up to the edge, there was deep, straight down, right? All that's been dumped in there to keep us up. There's nowhere to swim. People would come here and swim.
It's nothing like what he was, I'm sure.
No, there's nowhere to swim. Water's too shallow. Yeah.
This is the water you drank from? Is this the one you're talking about?
Yeah. It's a natural spring. They couldn't stop that. No, the water's clear. It's clean. It's drinkable. Even to this day. Yes. There used to be a road around the edge, but they've chopped it all back, brought it all back in. The quarry was right down there where the line is. Oh yeah, this whole fucking piece was swathed out of here just to backfill, okay? All backfilled with rock. 360 acres. That's how much land is here. An exact circle. Hey, they had dogs in here. They were teaching dogs to kill birds. The naturalists one day, we came in and upset their whole wagon cart. It was only open to the privileged. They were throwing dead ducks around. The dogs were fetching them. That's what they're using this holy land for. That's the total scope of their ability to dig inside, go kill something. I haven't been here since the funeral, since the internment. And we'll smoke a joint where I, in the internment area, where he wanted to be.
Where is he? Is
up
close?
There.
Are we close?
Up ahead. All this has been bastardized. They're really good at that, being bastards. Must be a prerequisite to govern. No, the Reverend Tucker lays throughout here. All throughout there, all throughout in here. They'll never get him out of here now. Bastards.
You should sit down, enjoy, and have a nice break.
I'm getting dry. These put some shorts on. All throughout here is the Reverend. And all back in there. Take a little walk back there for a second. His son too. We put some of his ashes were spread here. Yeah, very rough terrain, eh?
Yeah.
Round in there. Quite a bit up here. This was and his son back in back through there. Yeah, you never get him out of here now. He's one with Clearwater Abbey.
Are you walking any farther, Michael, or are you staying there?
I'm staying here. Okay. Yeah, this is holy ground. It's sacred ground. It's a burial ground now. Burial. A good place for people to come and spread their ashes. Rest with the Reverend. Brother Walter, A. Tucker. See how clear the water is? I may have swam in there. I think I did. And you can go in there, but you can't tread water. I mean, it's not for swimming. You could jump in there. I might do that. Yeah, that's where I was, in there. That's all that's left. Water's not as clear as it used to be.
There is some life in there, though.
Oh, fuck. Yes, there's fish. We used to swim in here. It's a good place for frogs now, not for people. But you know, I could still come here and dive in there. You know what they'd do? They'd throw more rocks in. Well, if I was swimming in there, they'd come and put more rocks in.
Seriously?
Oh yeah. Well, look at what they did.
Just to discourage you.
Yes. So nobody could get in the water. For this, they'll pay. I believe that there is a God that'll get them. But it won't be me. They'll have to atone to their own God someday. As wonderful as they think they are, they may not be so wonderful in reality. Look at the wall there. That was like that all the way around. Just a rock wall. At least that high. It's gone. Nerve of them. Well, let's get out of here. I'll light this joint up because I should smoke a joint with Brother Walter.
That's a ceremonial joint for old Brother Walter.
Yes, God bless you, Brother Walter. Rest in peace. I'm sure he is. He knew how to rest well, eh? After all, he was an electrician. And nobody gets paid more than electricians. Maybe lawyers and doctors, I guess. He was a good electrician too, Reverend Tucker. And we miss him. He added a lot to our lives. Rest in peace. And bless you, bless you. He always said that.
Did he?
Bless you, bless you.
You can just hear him say that, I'm sure, just standing here.
Yeah, yeah.
This is special. So how many others have brought you down here to record your memory of this?
No, just you and Lee was here.
Is that your...
He didn't catch us with the internment.
Is that your documentarian?
Yeah, yeah. He was a little late for the internment part, but he got a lot of footage. Yeah. He's supposed to be doing a documentary on the church.
Well, if I can help him some way, I'll be happy to.
Yeah, sure. Or maybe you could help him, I don't know. Huh. Oh, well, tell you what, just give it to God and leave it there for the Reverend to smoke. It's the best way to do it. Put it in the water. Don't start a fire. You go, Brother Walter.